Hi guys, this is Sri. So in this video, I'm going to explain about the importance of log slave updates in MySQL chain replication. Okay, so this is our topic today. So log slave updates means it's a MySQL variable. So in shortly, in this video, I'm going to cover the purpose of the log slave updates and how it is working. I will show the demo on that log slave updates. And also I have the use cases how the log slave updates variable is useful in the MySQL chain. Okay. So as usual, I have prepared three servers this time. Let me make it in name. Okay. So here MySQL. I'm just adding the prompt name to avoid the confusion. Okay. MySQL. So this is the AAA server. So let me log in. Yeah. So here you can see this is the MySQL AAA server. And the next one is. I'm just marking this MySQL BB. Okay. MySQL. This is the MySQL BB. Yeah, so this is MySQL BB, and the next one is the MySQL CC. I'm just adding the group to change the prompt name. You can directly use --- prompt option during the login, and you can also mention persist in the MySQL configuration file so that you cannot need to provide on each login. Okay, it will pick the value from my.cnf and it will make that prompt. Okay. Yeah, so this is the MySQL. Okay, there is a spelling mistake. Prompt. Okay, so this is the MySQL CC. So as I told, I have three servers. One is the MySQL AAA and the MySQL BBB and the MySQL CC. Okay. So about this MySQL prompt, if you want to change your MySQL prompt, you need to define in the prompt section under the MySQL group in the my.cns. Otherwise, you can also use the directly use like this prompt option. You can also directly use the prompt option here. Whatever you would like to have, you can mention. Okay. Okay. Let's come to the topic. So here, I already configured the replication. A is the source. This is the master. A is the master. A is the master. And BB is the slave. Okay. Just consider the A and B server at the moment. Okay. We can ignore the C now. Now let me tell the theoretical explanation about the log slave updates. So what is log slave updates? Okay. So just assume that you have the replication setup AA2. BB, okay. So whenever the write happens in the AAA, the data will be written in the bin log of the AAA. So when the BB IO thread will copy the data from the AAA's bin log and it will store in the BB's relay log. Okay. So if you enable the bin log in the BB, it will not store the data in the binary log. So what are the data it is copying from the AA server? Those will be stored in the BB's relay log only. Okay. So whenever the direct write happens on the BB, then it will be written in the bin log, binary log, BB's binary log. But without the direct writes, whatever data is replicating from the from the master, those data will be stored in the BB's relay log only. It will not store in the bin log. But whatever direct writes happen on the BB, it will be stored in the BB binary log. Okay. So now, if you enable the log slave updates on the BB server, the data copy from the AA will also return in the relay log and the bit log. Okay. So without log slave updates, I mean, if your log slave updates is disabled, the data from the AA will be copied and stored in the BB's relay log only. But if you enable the log slave updates, then the data from the AA, bin log data from the AA will be written in the BB's binary log and the relay log as well. Okay. So this is the, explanation about the log slave updates. I mean, what it is doing. Now let me show the demo so that you can understand this better. Okay. Now, let me show the show slave status first. I would like to use replica status because the slave status is deprecated. Okay, so it will be removed on the upcoming versions. So instead of show slave status, it is recommended to use the show replica status. Okay, so the source host, I mean the master host is 161. This is the master. 161, this is the master. Okay. And the replica IO thread and the SQL thread both are running. Okay. Now, let me do one quick query. Server ID, log bin, and log slave updates. Okay. So now, this is the slave node. Slave node, I have the server ID 101 and the log bin means binary log is enabled. And the log slave updates, it is disabled right now. Okay. And this is my master, I mean source. In the source, I have the server ID 100. And here the log bin is enabled and log slave updates also enabled. Okay. Now, let me do the show schemas. We have only default things. And the B also, I'm giving the show schemas. Okay, nothing. Okay, now I'm going to create one database on the source, I mean master node. Okay, create database, test. I'm just creating the test database, test underscore. Okay, I just created this database. Now, if I give the show schemas, yeah, the test is here. And it is also replicated in the B. I mean, the because we have the replication configured, so it is replicated in the B as well. Now, let me see show binary logs. Let me see this binary log. This is the slave's binary log. The data has been written through the replication threads. Okay, we did not done the direct write on the B, but we write on the A server and it is replicated on the okay. Now let's see the bin log. Okay, MySQL bin log base 64 output equal to decode rows, and I'm just seeing the bin log content. Okay, so we need to use the MySQL bin log to view the binary logs. I already posted a video about this. I will share the link in the description. Just take a look at it. Okay. So when I check the bin log, the create database statement is not available in the slave. Okay. Now, if you check the master, okay, now if you check the same on the master, here I just need to replace the bin log name. Okay, if you check here, you can see the create database statement in the master. Okay, so this is expected because whenever the direct write happen on the master, it will be written in the bin log and the slave will be copy the data from bin log and it will be applied. Okay, so it is expected. We have the data in the slave. I mean the test database is created on the slave in the replica, but the bin log don't have that content. I mean the create database statement is not logged in the replicas binary log. Okay, now let me enable the log flavor updates. So currently log flavor update is off. Now I am turning on the log flavor updates here. Actually, it needs the MySQL restart. You cannot do that on the runtime. Okay, so I enabled in the CNF, and I am going to restart the MySQL service on the slave, on the replica. Okay, the restart is happening. Yeah, restart is done. Now let's see again the values. Yeah, now the log slave update is enabled on the replica in the slave. Okay, now let's create another database. So I'm doing create database. Test one. I am just creating test one. Okay. Now let's see it is replicated on the slave or not first. Okay. So it is replicated. Now let's see the binary log on the replica. Okay. So here the latest bin log is 8. I'm just viewing the bin log. See, now you can see the create database statement, create database test one on the replica as well. Okay, so this is what the variable log slave update is doing. Okay, so when you enable the log slave updates variable, it will also write the statement from the source in the bin log. Okay, if it is disabled, it will only write in the relay log. But if you have the log slave updates enabled, then it will be, the data will be written in also the binary logs. Okay, here you can confirm that using the server ID. Actually, this is the master server ID. The event is from the master server ID. It is 100, right? Here you can check. Yeah, so the master server ID is 100. here you can, the event is from the server ID 100. You can confirm that. If you do the direct writes on the replica itself, just let me create one more database. This is I'm doing on the replica. I'm just doing on the only on the replica. So here you can see the create databases AAA. Here you can see the server ID is 101 because this is the direct writes on the replica. Okay, so it will, the events will be written with the server ID from the replica server ID. Okay, the replica server ID is 101. So we made the direct write, so create database AAA. So the event is have the server ID 101. But here this create database statement is from master. It is replicated statement, but it is also written in the bin log because we enable the log slave updates variable. So you can differentiate the statements based on the server ID. See here the server ID is 100. Okay, so using this server ID, you can understand, okay, so these are the statements are coming from the master. Okay, if you have the server ID 101, okay, these are the statements are directly executed on the slave. So you can just differentiate by using this server ID. Okay, so this is the function how the log slave update is working. Okay, so now let's go to the next server. We have the another server. It is called a CCC. Okay, so I already configured the replication. Let me show schemas here. Yeah. So let me make it consistent. Drop database test one. Test underscore A. I just did on the master. And also drop database AA. Okay, in B also we have the same schemas now. And finally, this is the CC. Drop database A. Okay, so let me quickly fix this. Stop slave set global. Okay, this one also I need the skip. Yeah. So now the data is consistent across all the databases. Okay. So we don't have any additional schemas. Only we have the default databases. Okay. Now, let me show the scenario. So when the Logsley updates are useful. Okay. Now consider the another server C in the topology. So I have AAA, BBB, and CC. BB is replicating from the AA and CC is replicating from the BB. Okay. So in this case, whatever direct writes happen in the AA will be replicated to the BBB. So whatever direct writes happen to the BB will be replicated to CC. Okay. Now the CC also need the data from AA, right? Because the BB is under AA and the CC is under BB. Okay, so in this case, whatever data writes happen in the AA server, those data needs to be written in the CC as well. Okay, but as per the current configuration, whatever direct writes happen in the BB will be replicated to the CC. Okay, whatever direct writes happen in the BB, those data will be written in the BB spin block and it will be replicated to the CC. But CC will never get the data from the AA. Okay, because those AA data will be written to the BB spin log without Logsley updates. So if you enable the, if you achieve this replication setup, this chain replication setup, in this case, you need to enable the Logsley updates on the BB server. Okay, so in this case, if you enable the Logsley updates on the BB server, whatever dates are written in the AA will be written in the BB's binary log and the relay log as well. So whatever data is written in the BB's binary log, those will be replicated to the CC server as well. Okay. So this is the way you can achieve all the data will be replicated to the CC. Without the Logsley updates enabled, the BB's bin log only have the direct writes data. Whatever direct writes happen on the BB server, those data will be written in the BB. Okay. So to achieve this, we need to have the Logsley updates on the BB. So let me show the direct demo so that it would be helpful to understand you better. Now this is the BB server. Let me Logsley updates. So currently it is enabled. Okay, now let me create one database on the AA server. I'm creating on the AA. And the name is EZ. Okay, I just mentioned EZ. Now let's see the show schemas on the all the server. Okay, so it is available on the AA server. I'm executing on the BB. BB server also have the EZ database. And I am executing on the CC server. CC also have the EZ database. Now, I'm going to disable the Logsley updates on the BB server, okay, the middle server. As I told you before, it needs the MySQL restart. I'm just restarting the BB node. Yeah, so it is restarted and I am checking the Logsley updates Okay, so it is zero. Zero means it is disabled right now. Okay, now I am just going to drop the database. Is it? Drop database. Is it? I did the drop on the A circle. Okay, I did on the A. Now let's see, show schemas on the B. It is dropped because B is the slave. It is a replica of A server. Okay, replication is running. Now let's see on the C server. It is not dropped. Okay, the EZZ database is still available. Let's see the show slave status here. Okay. Yeah, so the replication is running on the CC. Let's see the database is available. Also. See, the replication is running on the CC server. It is running. And but if you see the EZZ, the schema is still available on the C node. Okay, the C is replica of B. B means this is 172.28.0.96. This is the B side. Okay, so this is the B side. So what happens? The day we did the drop on the A, we did the drop statement here. It is replicated to the BB, but it is not replicated to the CC because we disable the logslay updates. So if we disable the logslay updates, the drop statement will not be written on the BB's binary log. Okay, if you check the BB's binary log, the drop statement will not be there. So the latest bin log is 99. If you see the drop statement is not there because we disable the logslay updates. Okay, so the drop statement is not replicated to the CC server because whatever data is written in the bin logs, those data will be replicated to the replicas. Due to the logslay updates disabled, the data is not written in the BB's bin log and it is not replicated. So this is the reason if you want to achieve this the replication architecture in this kind of chain replication, then you should make sure to enable the logslay updates variable on the needed servers, okay, so that your data will be written in the all the submasters bin logs as well. Okay, to ensure the consistency, you should make sure about this logslay updates variable. So yes, and also if you want to go just as a backup, if you want to keep the, I mean, the bin log data in your slaves as well, for that kind of purpose also, you can enable the logslay updates apart from this replication. Okay, so hopefully this video is helpful to understand about the logslay updates variable and how it is helpful in the replication architecture, and how to differentiate the view of the bin logs based on the server ID if you enable the logslay updates. So you might have some questions or if something is confusing and if something is not clear, just give me the feedback in the comment or just directly reach me and give your feedback so that I can correct it. And if you like this video, just share with your friends who is learning MySQL and subscribe my channel to see lot of videos related to the MySQL going forward. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.